Hey there, this is Luke from Korneff Audio with today's classic track, Mixover, in which I take the pawn shop comp and slap it on a classic recording and tootle around to make it sound better. And in doing so, demonstrate the amazing versatility and power of the pawn shop comp, because it's amazing and it's powerful and it's versatile. So this week's recording is White Room by Cream. So 1968, started it in England, finished it off in New York City at Atlantic Studios. So this is probably, I'm going to guess it's an 8-track. Because only the Beatles were still hanging around on 4-track in 1968. So I think this is an 8-track recording. Could be 4-track. I think it's 8-track. And we're going to listen to it right now. This is, what can I say? It's one of the best things ever. So there's a viola in there. Viola. Some guys singing. Guitars, bass. Timpanis. Then it kicks in.
In the white room with black curtains near the station.
Okay, so
black roof country.
This is the coolest drum part. And one of the pities of this particular recording is that we don't hear those drums kind of better, and there's really no bottom end on them. If this was a modern recording, those drums would be huge. I know this is kind of sacrilege, but they would be huge. I have the isolated drum track here, and I don't know how they made this. They probably used a plug-in, but here we can, it's let's listen to it. So you can hear a little bit of the room on it. Now I'm listening to that, and I'm hearing that that's compressed. And in 1968, it's probably running through like an LA-2, or if it's in New York, yeah, probably like an LA-2 or something like that. And one of the things about a tube compressor is they are not typically punchy, especially tube compressors of that time, because they use something called a soft knee. And the net result is there's not a lot of attack. And that's one of the things we're really losing on this recording, is you don't get that kind of that great smack.
Light smile on you,
right? I mean, the drums are kind of blup blup sounding as opposed to whack whack sounding. There are some technical terms for you. So I'm going to put the drums through the pawn shop comp, and I'm just going to let you hear what I did so we don't have to spend too much time noodling. So it's out. Okay. I guess I could get the, let me see if I drop this output a little bit and try to match this level a little better. Well, you know, that's kind of matching, but the pawn shop is doing a lot of work to it. So, what do I got here? 13 to 1. Let me stop this. 13 to 1 compression ratio. Pretty quick release. Very slow attack. Now, I'm slowing down the attack because I want to bring out the smack. And really, it's about the only way I can do it. By slowing down the release, I bring out the room. And you can hear this. Let me just... I'll slow down the release and the room goes away. I speed up the release, and all that resonance and ring of the drums comes out. And that's real typical of drums and releases, right? If you set a fast release, you're going to bring up the room and the quiet stuff. If you set a longer release, you're going to smush that stuff down. Now, I'm also doing a couple things in the pawn shop's tweakable back end here. So off to the other side, and I'm using the preamps. And actually both the bias and the preamp control to drive the signal a little bit more, which is generating some harmonic distortion. And I'm using the operating level to just, again, push it a little bit, drive some more high end, because it's not a particularly bright recording. And then I've got the weight, which is a low peaking EQ. I think it's centered around 120 cranked up. I'll turn this in and out so you can hear the difference. So here's the weight out. Here's weight all the way up. You can see it's not doing a lot, and there's not a lot to grab to down there. In 1968, there's not a lot of bass on records because you physically couldn't fit that on the vinyl. Not if you were making a full length. So we're going to lose some bottom end that even the pawn shop comp can't return to the mix. But still sounds good. I'm going to play with the preamp here, let you hear what it's doing. You can see it's really affecting that upper mid. Now the bias... Oh man, that sounds so good. But we'll put it here. Operating level... Let's click back. Operating level tends to give some fairly unpredictable results, but it's working nice on this. Now that isn't just a volume increase, that's an increase in presence too. So here's before, there's after, and that's better. That's a pretty good sounding drum track. Here's before. Oh, he was a great player. Okay, so that's just playing with the individual drum track. I can put that individual drum track in on the main track. Now, of course, the drums are going to get a little louder because they're going to, you have a drum track laid over the main mix and it's going to double up the drums a little bit. And I got these synced as much as possible. I'm using MP3s off YouTube, so the sound quality is terrible. But for our purposes, it kind of works. So here's the back to cream. And now I'm going to add in my drums. Drums out. That's in. You can hear all that resonance and tone from the kettle drums brought up by the pawn shop. Let's kick in a little. I want to hear it get to where it's going. She was kindness in the... And here's in. All right, so that's pretty good. That's pretty good. Let us play with the entire track now. I have a pawn shop that I'm slapping over the entire track. So let's just mute out the drums, and I'm going to pop that in a little bit. At curtains near the station. I guess I could get the... Seems a little loud. This is so subjective, this loudness. Let me see. Payment, tired starlings. Silver horses ran down moonbeams in your dark eye. In this case, the pawn shop is actually misset a little bit, so it's making things quieter, and it's still bringing up the drums. Listen to that. That's cool. I'd smile on you leaving my contentment. Bringing up everything. Okay, my settings are a little different, but not too much. My release is a little longer because I want to avoid pumping up the vocals too much. My ratio is lower and my threshold is higher, so it's not hitting as hard. But it's doing about the same thing. Again, I'm trying to increase the attacks and trying to increase the details and the resonances in the drum set and not hit too much of the main track. All right, and if I go to the other side here, oh, look at that. It's pretty similar. Pretty similar. I got a little bit of... a little bit of bias up, and a little bit of preamp up, and a little bit of weight, and a little bit of focus. Now, too much of the weight, it tends to not do much because there's not much down there on the recording. Let's hear that. Right? See, there's nothing to hit. Now on the Focus,
you said no strings could secure you.
Right there, you really hear the way the pawn shop is bringing up the echo on the voice and the room sound on the drums. I'm going to pop it out, and we're just going to run that section over again. If we can hit it there.
You said no strings.
Okay, so you have that wonderful doot-doot-doot-doot drum fill and the vocals. Let's hear that one more time. Oh, let's hear the...
You said no strings.
Okay, so now I'm going to pop this in, and let's hear the exact same thing.
You said no strings.
Quite a difference. And that's the pawn shop bringing up those details, bringing up that quiet stuff. It's very good. And the last thing I'm doing on the PSC to work with this recording is I'm using the wet dry and I'm backing off a little bit. And the reason I'm doing this is because even though this is an MP3 and it probably has nothing happening above, I don't know, 15,000 hertz or something like that with a recording this old, I'm still hearing a little bit of high-end loss with the pawn shop in. And this is actually... The pawn shop is not a super high-end... The pawn shop actually has a roll-off starting at about 14,000 hertz, and that's to mimic some of the vintage gear. And the next version of the pawn shop will have the ability to defeat the roll-off, so you won't have to do this little trick that I'm doing now, which is to actually just back down the pawn shop effect and bleed back in some of the original track to restore some of the highs, but also just to downplay the whole effect a little bit. I like that control a lot for this. So here's full. That's full dry. That's the original recording. That's full wet. Oh, I guess I could play with this more. It's so subjective. And here it is.
In the white room.
And here it is all the way. And I'm going to back it off and just open up the highs a little bit. And the last thing I got going, I think, yeah, I'm using, there's two different sets of FET transistors I can switch between. And, I'm not going to go by the numbers, but there's the one on top and then there's the one on the bottom. And the one on top sounds one way and the one on the bottom sounds another. And the one on the bottom is usually a little bit rougher sounding and a little more unpredictable. And the one on top is usually a little smoother. So I can switch between them. We'll see what it does. Keep doing that. I hate logic sometimes. So that's the top. I'm hearing it mainly in the release on this. It seems with the top FET that the release is a little faster and it pumps a little more. And on the bottom, it's a little smoother on the release. And this is kind of the opposite of how this... sometimes works, but there's an unpredictability to vintage gear, and there's an unpredictability to the pawn shop, and that's one of the things that's really cool about it. And you want a little bit of unpredictability. Happy accidents always something you want in the recording studio.
Restless diesels, goodbye windows.
Yeah, see, it's better, definitely.
Such a sad time at the station.
And there we have today's classic track mixover, Cream's White Room, and the Pawn Shop comp doing the dirty work, bringing up the drums, bringing up the resonance, doing all the things it does, adding slap, tickle, distortion, whatever. And I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you learned a little bit about Cream, a little bit about vintage recording, a little bit about compressors and what they can do on drums. This is Luke for Korneff Audio saying sayonara. I hope you go out and make great recordings, make great music.